Hi, I'm Mark Doff, Curator of History at Gilcrease Museum. Our museum's founder, Thomas Gilcrease, amassed a collection that today numbers more than 350,000 items. I'm often asked just how Mr. Gilcrease built such a massive and impressive collection. While some of the objects came into his collection as a single purchase, many came into the museum as fully formed collections, like that of early Western art collector, Dr. Philip Gillette Cole. These are the collections of other collectors. Some, like Cole's, contain many hundreds of items. Today, I would like to share with you the backstory of what I feel was one of the most significant purchases Mr. Gilcrease ever made. This was his purchase of 5 very special documents and a painting. Together, they provide us in the 21st century with essential insights into the founding of our nation. This story begins in 1946, just after World War II. That's when a Washington bureaucrat in the Truman administration had the idea to develop a display of objects that would help define the American values that President Franklin Roosevelt had expressed in his 1941 For Freedom speech. These were the ideals that Roosevelt hoped to extend throughout the world after the Allies' victory over the Axis powers. These ideals were freedom of expression, freedom of religion, freedom from want, and freedom from fear. This idea for a display of documents and other related items eventually became the Freedom Train. The Freedom Train was a traveling museum designed to provide the American people with an exhibition of patriotic objects documenting the nation's heritage of freedom and the many sacrifices made over the years to preserve that freedom. Between September 1947 and July 1949, the exhibition's 126 items were seen in all 48 states. The exhibition traveled in 7 cars pulled by the 2,000 horsepower Spirit of 1776 locomotive and was guarded by 29 United States Marines who had served the nation during World War II. During the Freedom Train's tour of the nation, it traveled more than 37,000 miles, made stops in 326 cities, and provided more than 3.5 million Americans the opportunity to see items like the Declaration of Independence, the Bill of Rights, and the Emancipation Proclamation. Even President Harry S. Truman took time out of his busy schedule to visit the Freedom Train. So what is the connection between Thomas Gilcrease and the Freedom Train? Well, after visiting the Freedom Train at a stop in Oklahoma, Mr. Gilcrease made arrangements to acquire 6 objects for his yet-to-open museum once the train completed its run on July 4, 1949. 5 of these objects are handwritten documents that are some of the most treasured objects in the museum's collection. They are Paul Revere's certified pass of April 29, 1775, which allowed Revere to move about the Boston area to warn of British troop movements. Thomas Jefferson's letter to his close friend William Fleming, dated July 1, 1776. In this letter, Jefferson detailed what had been happening in Philadelphia and New York, but could not divulge to Fleming what had occupied most of his time that fateful summer. But Jefferson ends his letter with a hint, writing, "My country will have my political creed in the form of a declaration." That political creed was the Declaration of Independence. The final 3 Freedom Train documents that Mr. Gilcrease purchased were used by Benjamin Franklin in 1777 as part of his diplomatic communications with the court of Frederick the Great of Prussia. These documents are Franklin's official letter of introduction to the court, a copy of the Declaration of Independence in the hand of Silas Deane, who served with Franklin in Paris, and a handwritten copy of the Articles of Confederation, our new nation's first form of government. Using these foundational documents, Franklin made it known to Frederick the Great that we, the new United States of America, were a free and independent nation. The 6th item Mr. Gilcrease acquired was a visual reminder of the document that established America's federal government in 1787. This is the painting, The Signing of the Constitution, completed by Howard Chandler Christie in 1937, that celebrates the 150th anniversary of the signing. Gilcrease's purchase of this very large and allegorical work was the beginning of an artist-patron relationship that lasted until Christie's death in 1952. But that's a story for another day. In the meantime, please plan to visit Gilcrease Museum's collection online site. There you can see these and tens of thousands of other wonderful objects that Thomas Gilcrease collected for the benefit of us all. Thank you for joining me today. Until next time, take care and be well.